So that's where I think right now in boxing there's not really one pound for pound guy, because if you ask 10 people, maybe half of them are gonna say different names.
Yeah.
Maybe none of them are gonna say the same name. That means there's not a pound for pound. Years ago, you would say who's pound for pound the best fighter, and a lot of people would say Manny Pacquiao. A lot of people, and then Mayweather. Nobody would say anybody else but Mayweather. Pound for pound, who's the best fighter? Mayweather. Out of 10 people would say it was Mayweather. Right now, you ask 10 people, and everybody's gonna have a different opinion. So that's why it's hard to say. It depends on who you're asking, I guess.
No, it makes sense.
That's who you ask.
Yes.
You know, De La Hoya was, you know, Trinidad. You know, I remember Trinidad, De La Hoya, Vargas. We're all three, like, in that mix. It was competitive. You know, Trinidad beat both of them. So, you know what I mean? Then you could put, oh, then it's Trinidad. But it was, like, between all three. It's right now, it's just too many. Right now, it's too many that you could say who really is number one pound for pound. It's hard. It's hard. Me? I think Lomachenko, because he's got skills. He's got skills. And
So you believe?
He fights, you know, his style, you know, he brings, people want to watch him fight, people want to see, and the way he fights, it's something you want to see what he's going to do. You want to see what footwork he's going to use. So it is entertaining. I like watching his fights. I seen his fight, and he look good. He's fast. He's, there's a lot of punches, and that doesn't mean he cannot get, you know, he can be beat. But at his level, at his fighters, he's dominating and he's looking really good. But, you know, he moves up to 135, I think he'll get beat. I really do. That's my opinion. And, you know.
Well, I mean, that's realistically, that's your job, right? If you guys are, like, you know, considering going against him moving up, not your job. I didn't mean it like that. But you know what I'm saying, like. I mean, you're gonna look at your fighter, and you're gonna, yeah, you're gonna,
you know, I see his fights, and I see talent wise, he's the best fighter right now in the world because of what he's done, what he's shown in the fights. He gets hit. It's not like he doesn't get hit. You know, he hardly gets hit, but he's very smart and he's very accurate with his punches. But you know, I think he's more, he's very fast, smart. But at 135, you know, it's going to be a big, different story. Like, opponents are going to be way different. They're not going to be...
Well, even just like what he's saying, like just like with Triple G, you know, him moving around in weight, like exactly. It looks different. It's just different.
Weight, but he was fighting guys that were, you know, that were not in his level. And then comes a guy that might be in his level and gave him problems.
Oh, so he didn't move around in weight.
No, he was he's the same weight, but it was this one guy that was good enough to give him a hard time. And everybody else, he was knocking out easy, and this guy gave him a hard time. You know, if you have that pound-for-pound fighter, he's got to dominate everybody that they put in front of him. There comes that day where he gets beat. Obviously, everybody gets beat one day. But right now, there's not that one guy that stands out as the best pound-for-pound. I don't see it. I don't see him.
Soon.
So that's where I think right now in boxing there's not really one pound for pound guy.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.